Hey everybody, welcome to the next session of Let's Play Dragon Quest VIII on the 3DS. In the last session, we went to Ascantha and helped out Emma the Maid, and we also saved King Pavan from his two-year-long mourning period for his late wife, Sasha, or Sasher, according to Emma. Emmer, and also the place we were at as Ascanther. Anyway, this episode, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go find the monster. I know where it is. I found it. So I'm going to do it real quick. Take the picture. It's the last picture we need to take for this area. Go to the guy. He's probably going to give us something badass, or he's going to give us something useless. I get the feeling that this time it's going to be useless, because last time it was really good. There it is right there. But who knows? Maybe it's something even better. Okay. Careful. I don't want to attract the attention of another monster. Perp! Oh, yes. That's a good picture. Yeah. Okay. And we will change the pose. How about... that. Perfect. Okay. Alright, now hopefully this thing's not too difficult. I fought the cream thing. Slime, whatever. Oh yeah, also, both my character and Angelo both leveled up while I was fighting the mummies to get this one to appear, so, they leveled up, they got some skill points, but I didn't allocate them yet. I'll do that after this. Okay. Let's just go all out. Angela learned a new skill, which is a very useful one, Kabuff, which raises the defense of all party members. I'll go ahead and do that. I also have fast motion on. How much damage does this thing do? Not that much. Wait. Okay. Angelo, use the staff! You know what, if they kept the multi-thrust sound effect the same, why didn't they keep the Twin Dragon Lash sound effect the same? They kept the parallax sound effect. They even kept that it sometimes doesn't really sync up with what's actually happening, like the audio. That's not me, that's the game doing that. If you're noticing, like, isn't that happening, like, before? Isn't the sound effects happening before the stuff is on screen? Yeah, that's just, for some reason, parallax does that. Like, that was even in the original game. They didn't take that out, so why did they change Twin Dragon Lash? I don't know. Okay, now Yang is leveled up. So, that's good. Okay. And now to do the skill points. There we go, spears. Critical hit rate, and then eventually we'll learn clean sweep, which will make it so that I can hit a group of enemies with a spear, which is very useful. I become a legendary lancer, the chance of me landing a crit increases. Okay. Angelo. There you go, buddy, I know you want it. 48 points will get Caduceus, which is awesome. It's like a mid-heal, which we haven't learned yet. It's like a mid-heal, but it's free, so... it's good. You can only use it during battle, though. That's a high warlock and bounce. He becomes a conjurer, and he learns drain magic. It's not very, it doesn't really work that much, but I don't know. Let's talk, see what people have to say. Grandub's upset because he always gets treated like a monster, and we ain't got no clue where the Omegas is, neither. I'm telling you, we should go to me hometown, pick 'em. Granddad will be able to go where he wants, and I bet we'll get some stuff on Dual Magus and all. Pickham's really roughly south of Iskantha. It's a bit of a way, but it'll be worth it. Oh, okay. Alright. But before we do that, I'm just gonna go back to Port Prospect. You know what's really strange? Is that there's this guy on YouTube who's playing this game. It's like, his name's like Beard Bear or something. And he was the guy, I think I told you about, that like had like 12 or so hours of the game like played and uploaded to YouTube before the game was even released. So let me take a look at this stamp. Oh, okay. A poison needle. Well, I used it in a mix, so it's not so bad. But what is it gonna give me? A new sticker, anything else? That's it? Okay, well, whatever. Not so great. Anyway. Okay, as I was saying. Well, he's like, he does a lot of other stuff too. Like, he's playing like Wind Waker, he's playing Yoshi's Woolly World and stuff, and apparently he does like full 100% of stuff, and he does other things, and I'm like, and they're all like hour long, and I'm like, how does this guy make all of this stuff? Does he not have like anything else to do? Like, I'm really curious. Like, it just, because he has so much stuff. And here's the weird thing. He uploaded a video, and he puts titles on them too. So from the title, I was able to tell that he was, of the video that he put out, that he was about halfway through Dragon Quest VIII. And then the very next video, he was only halfway through the videos uploaded. The next video he uploaded of it is like final boss plus ending. I'm like, what? But you're only halfway done. But then it hit me. No, that means he's all the way done. He just hasn't uploaded it yet. So when the hell did he get the time to record the whole fucking game? I have no idea. It's crazy. Like, I wish I could do what he does. He only has like 3,000 more subscribers than I do, so I don't really understand how he like got the game earlier, whatever the hell he did. I have no idea. It's crazy. Yeah, but now, this guy's a dick. He can attack twice. And of course he attacks Jessica twice, but she can take it because she's awesome. But anyway, yeah, like, I just don't get it. How is he able to do that? I don't know. Again, like, maybe if this was the only game he was playing, then I'd be like, oh, okay, I guess he's just, you know, he had like a lot of free time in order to like do this one thing. But no, he's got like all this other shit too. I just don't understand. Maybe I could ask him. Although, if I actually asked him, I'd probably ask him like an asshole, to be honest. I probably wouldn't be like, hey, how'd you do that? Like, I'd really like to know. Like, how do you find the time to do this? Or, like, what do you use to record? Or, like, what? No, I wouldn't do like that. I wouldn't be polite. I'd probably be like, you fucking piece of human garbage. How dare you? How dare you move in on my Dragon Quest Let's Play? You should be ashamed of yourself, good sir. I would still say good sir, just to, you know, let him know that I am a gentleman, but I am very peeved. But no, I don't really care that much. It's just crazy. I don't get it. But anyway, enough about him. Let's kill you. Let's fight these things because I like them. What are they called again? Like hooded something? just hoods. Okay. These guys, I'm kind of strong, so I'm just gonna try and get rid of them, like, immediately. Instead of doing my regular, strategy. There we go. Come on. Health. There we go. Okay. Now those things suck, those gorilla things. Oh, and those things suck. Those imps? Yeah, no. Fuck those things. I say fucking avoid them if you can. But anyway, we need to go this way. Well, we don't need to, but I'd like to. I always go this way, at least. One time. Hey, you there. I'll fight them just once. I'm sure they won't do the bad thing. I'm sure they won't. I'm sure they'll be fine. Oh, no. Actually, bang. Bang does good damage on machines too, so that'll be good for those robot things. Come on. Oh, what? Alright. We're good. Wait a minute, didn't I use Mercurial Thrust? Oh, I used Thunder Thrust. I'm an asshole. I'm dumb. Okay, let's do it right this time. As you can see, they have a lot of defense, but they're weak to magic, especially, bang-type magic. Okay, well, they're also weak to critical hits, but then again, everything is. Welcome to the Lakeside Cabin. It's a wonderful place for travelers on their way to Escantha and Pickham to have a rest. Let's do it. But first, anything interesting to say now? It's weird to see King Troad suddenly go off in a sulk like that. He's usually so full of beans and everything. I guess he must be starting to feel the pressure. Hopefully, going to that town might cheer him up a bit. Do you think I'll really be able to walk around that town without any problems? That's what Yangus seems to think, but how can I trust the likes of him? Oh, I don't know. People say me old town Pickham's full of crooks and the like, but it's actually not a bad place, really. I bet it's the only town in the world where a funny-looking character like the old codger could walk around without getting no grief. Who are you calling funny-looking, and do you really think it's safe? No probs! You worry too much, Granddad. I don't know. I'd been starting to wonder whether King Troad really is a king, but that little display has taken care of any doubts. That kind of self-centeredness smacks of royalty, that's for sure. King Troad, do you actually have anything interesting to say in battle records? You've certainly covered a fair distance now. You should enter the next Trodian Marathon. I'm sure you'd do rather well. Now, this always has information that I already know. It's the recipe for a snakeskin whip, I'm pretty sure. Yep. Yeah. Just checking. Alright. Okay. Ah, there's a priest. Okay, he's right there. We don't need him. We're fine. Okay. Now, the imps are, they're not imps. They're mini demons, that's what they're called. The reason why they're dangerous is because they have the spell Frizzle. Which is just a more powerful version of Frizz, the fire... What the... What is that? Is that... Was that there? Okay, I'm gonna go get this chest over here first. And I don't remember there being like an archway right there. Maybe I'm just crazy. Oh, frick. Maybe I do. What does the sign say? No. Yeah, this is new. It had to load this part of the world. Okay. Yeah, I wasn't going crazy. Yeah, that wasn't in the original. So, anything new to say now that we're in a new area? Nope. More importantly, any new pictures, though? Anything that I can take, like, right now? Nope. Alright. Well, time to look around. Why a bushwhacker? At least I think that's what his name is. Come here. Need to confirm. Not Headhunter. I think Bushwhacker is the name of, like, a version of those guys, though, like a different enemy. Just gonna make sure to get rid of these trees. Green Yangus has an axe. I think axe should be, like, super effective against tree, but I don't know. Oh, Yangus, you cut it down you cut it vertically, you should cut it horizontally. Ugh. There we go, like that. You're new, but I don't feel like fighting you though. Just looking, trying to go new ways to see if I can. Oh well, okay, hang on. This is very important right here. It's very, very, very important. Thank you. Whoop. Hang on. Okay. Oh, well. I was actually messing with the wires. Connecting to my 3DS, the charger, and the capture card wire thing. And I wasn't looking where I was going, and I got into a fight. Actually, I wasn't going anywhere. Is it just me, or did, like, the sound effects for these guys seem a little weird? They don't seem to play at, like, the right time. Yeah, see, it's like... I don't know, it's weird. What? Oh, but there is a chest right here that we can open. It's blue. Seat of agility. Nice. But this, I don't believe we can open. Yeah, alright. Still talking about beans. What's that? Is that beans? You guys know, yeah, if you don't watch Fine Sus, you probably wouldn't know that. I know that there are some different things to say up here. Nope. I guess it's after I talk to him. Or try to talk to him. Can we get out of here? I feel kind of uncomfortable. Feels good standing on the edge of a building like that, and I do it myself sometimes. What are you talking to me for? I don't have the answers to everything, you know.
Ah! You come to see me, and I ignore you! What was I thinking? Come, speak, I listen! Allow me to introduce myself. I am Mori. Here, I borrow my ears to the wind.
Hey, Mori's calling us. We should go over. I can't think of anything worse, but still. All that stuff about listening to the wind's pretty cool, eh, Guff? Maybe when I get older, I can start having the old chat with nature myself. Mori, hmm? Oh.
I hear it on the wind. There is someone magnifico come here soon. So, Bimba, you are a traveler, see?
No.
Then I ask you one favore. Here, take this. When we have finished talking, you take a look at these memos. Each one has written on the information of the notorious monsters. Find them! Fight them! Send them to me! It is not to worry, Bimba! For you, it will be a slice of cake! I see it in your eyes! Buona fortuna and good hunting!
Okay. Mori's memos. Yeah, I'm not really sure what it's all about, but I guess if we look at the memos, we should be able to figure it out. So all we have to do is to find and defeat the monsters on the memos. Sounds like a doodle. Or whatever. If only people always told it to you straight as them, eh? As you can probably tell, I'm a man of much experience. I know more than I'd care to know sometimes. But never before have I come across a man like him. He's one of a kind. take a look at the memos, I suppose. I already know what's on them, but I'll do it anyway. Spotted near a dilapidated castle, What about this one? Lonely Joe. Spotted on the riverbank near Myala Abbey. I think we've seen him before. Lakes like a wriggling plate of spaghetti. Okay, tossed in your face. Spotted at the water's edge near Lady Bandit's lair. Don't think we know about that one yet. I guess I'll have to keep my eyes peeled, huh? By the way, can we zoom here? Yes, we can. Okay, good. Good. Then I might as well just go ahead and get this out of the way. Sorry. Do you like that scratching beard sound effect? Do you like that? That scratching beard ASMR? Does it make your the hairs on the back of your neck stick up? I mean, it's nowhere near as good as the Funky Kong ASMR, but I mean, nothing really is. So, dude, how was your trip? Bodacious. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, it must have sounded really weird. Just. First of all, if you don't know what ASMR is, look it up. And then after that, look up Funky Kong ASMR, and it should be like a kind and something Funky Kong drives you home from the airport. It's the strangest thing. There we go. And now we have a Himmer taken care of. Oh crap, we're in a new area. We've made it to Mori's place. That might mean that... No, alright. We have to get to pick him first, I suppose. Alright. Fair enough. Okay. You know, in the original game, it was if you stay on the path that you would encounter less monsters. Like, the encounter rate on the road was less than out on the field. But in this game, you can just walk across the path and not have to worry about the whole... I guess there are more monsters there, but you can still just, you know, avoid them, so. Okay. Where's the dog? There should be a fucking dog out here. Where's the dog? I always love that dog. The dog always comes running to you. Like it loves you. Anyway. Yay, now we get to go here, and we get to do something dumb. Okay, not really.
Well, Yangus, at least you were right about something. No one here so much as bats an eyelid at me. So, the pub awaits. I'll go on ahead, and I wouldn't want to get in your way. You go and find this brains fellow. I'll be waiting for your report. Waiting? Boozing more like. Come on, Gov. Let's forget about him and head over to Brains's. Some of us have got to keep our minds on the job, eh? We've got to find that Dalmagus.
Okay. Life is full of surprises. I never thought I'd actually visit a town like this. Pickham and the place I grew up are like night and day. I was one hell of a thief back when I was living here. A real top-class bandit. but I got fed up with all that criminal stuff, so I decided to wash me hands of it and leave Pick'em for good. Goddess, how long has it been since I was last here? I wonder. It feels funny being back, I can tell ya. This place is filthy. Let's go find this information dealer, Brains, or whatever he's called, and bid farewell to this stench as quickly as we can. See, I like this because you would expect, like, Jessica to say something like that, but Angelo's the one who's kind of, like, prissy a little bit. He actually has more lines about this town that are pretty funny. I just like the first line, this town is filthy. Don't want it to mess up my hair. Okay. There are a few things we can do here. Chainmail, that's not good. Is that all there is in here? No wall bags, are there? Never know if they're wall bags. No, no wall bags. Also, yeah. Go in here real quick so I can... can I get out? Yeah, I can. Okay. Yes. Alright. Go in that door and go through there, because if you don't, you have to pay this guy to get through, so... just do that. Weapon shop. Poison mop, eh. Hunter, no. Nope. And, yep, alright, well, we don't need weapons. And now it's time to buy a stupid thing for Jessica, but whatever. It's not so bad. Bronze armor, no, leather cape. That'll be good for Angelo. And the dancer's costume. Good defense, but... it comes at a price. Now we have to look dumb. Well, not dumb, but we have to look dumb in a fight. It doesn't look like it would have more defense, of course, but it does. Whatever. It's fine. Let's see. Shield, fire ice, that's good. It's only two more attacks. Screw it, I'm just gonna get rid of the rapier. Actually, we might be able to use the rapier in a mix. I'll keep it for now. I don't know every mixture in this game, but I remember a few. We need that. Can keep that. That's really good. Don't think we need the scale shield. Wizard staff is good. Can make a lot of things out of it. Yeah, I think that'll do. Okay. I need to try something really quick. Okay, I thought maybe two bronze shields, putting them together makes bronze armor. I think that's something else. Anyway, okay, so I'm gonna sell the bronze shields then. I don't know what to make out of them. Wow, Angela has more defense than I do? Huh. Well. Well then, I guess that means I get it then. I need to sell your leather dress. Forgot about that. Really like to afford that. Well, we might find some money. Yeah. Hang on. I have the plain clothes. Oh. question. Is this the right mixture? Nope. Okay, it has to be. It's spicy cheese with two red molds. Or it's plain cheese with two red molds. Make a super spicy cheese. Or something like that. I think I'm pretty sure I need three spots. But anyway. Okay. There's a very important item we can find here, and I'm pretty sure we could have actually found this before, because I remember- oh, that's- well, I mean, that's important. Pretty good. We're gonna need a lot of life, actually, for this next thing that we're about to do. Because sometimes it doesn't go so well, but maybe today I'll be lucky. Yeah, fine, I'll read this. It gives away the recipe. I already know it, though. Personal diary. Dear diary, today I got one step closer to realizing my dream of becoming a bunny girl. I found a perfect bunny suit and a sexy pair of fishnet stockings, but I still can't find a set of bunny ears. A bunny without ears is like a quest without a dragon, so I decided to take matters into my own hands. I bought a hairband today to make my own. All I need to do is find some honey I can combine it with to make bunny ears. I'm so close. My little bunny tail is twitching with excitement. And we discover a new recipe for the alchemy pot, even though it doesn't tell us. Bunny ears equals hairband plus bunny tail. I could swear we could have found a bunny tail by now, but I'm pretty sure we can find one in this town. Like, I swear, I must have missed a chest or something, I don't know. Which is, you know, a great crime for me. Dictated by myself. I really shouldn't miss anything. But I am kind of trying to go a little bit faster than I normally play, so... let's see... anything else in here? No? Okay. And we can't open that yet, just in case if you were wondering. Cannot open. Do we find a ponytail here? I hope so. Oh, frick! Hang on. Take a look at the camera challenges. Okay. I don't know what they're called, but there's a type of monster that's twins. Apparently they're almost identical, but one's red and one's always yellow, I hear. Okay, I've seen them. Alright. It's the pack curve or something. Mori's minions. Apparently if you beat 30 mini-demons, peculiarly that's a hard word for me to say, apparently. Dressed monster appears on the coast between Iscantha and Pickham. It's a rather rare occurrence. Alright. A strange labyrinth in the vicinity of Pickham, where many statues of swordsmen can be found. Someone told me that there is a particularly impressive and large pair of them standing together inside the place somewhere. Could you snapshot of those two magnificent statues? Bandit Burrow. Pickham is a town famous for its rogues, scoundrels, bandits. I hear there's supposed to be a lookout post that commands a view over the whole town. Could you find it and take a picture to show me what the place looks like? Okay, I know where that is. Okay, apparently there's a particular place in Pickham where a secret society of suspicious individuals meet. There's some suggestion they may be called the Cleaners. Though the thought of dodgy dealings in underground and an already dodgy dive of Pickham is more than my curiosity can bear. I know where that is as well. Okay. There's a very intriguing rumor that somewhere not too far from Pickham is a mysterious circular building, inside of which there is some sort of secret coliseum. Could you find out if the rumors are true? And snap me a shot of the arena, if so? The arena, okay. Okay, it seems a golden slime, okay. Rance Dim, servant of the slums. So there's a fellow in that famous town full of scoundrels who knows everything about everything, okay. So there's a fortune teller, famous for getting things wrong, so no matter what teller, okay, yeah, got it. Awe-inspiring outlaw. There's a lady who's such a great thief, even the scoundrels are- okay, got it. Okay. I think this is the bunny tail. Come on. Or there's nothing in here, actually. Yeah, I think this girl says, like, we don't have anything useful here. You can take whatever you want. Okay. Yeah, hang on, let me confirm. Take it, whatever you want, but there's nothing of value in here, I swear. Huh? You're not burglars? Oh, I'm sorry, it's just been so many break-ins recently, I was sure. Most important kind of bag. Okay. No, I'm good. Just want to check your wall bag. There we go. Okay. Well, I guess I'll go ahead and get a picture of this. Here we go, here's the secret society. Welcome to Pick'em Secret Club. Hehehe. I don't really think there's... Actually, wait, no, I think there's like a... leather kilt or something? There's a mini metal. Oh, no, okay. Uh-oh. Alright. So this is it. Let's get a good pick. Can't zoom in more than this, really? I can zoom out, but not in. Alright. I guess that works then. Okay. Oh yeah, Yangus, let's use your special ability. Thanks to my Yangus card's special ability, I'm able to learn how many treasures there are in this town. There are 21. Don't want to go up there yet. Oh, hey! Yes! I know what you're thinking. Why are you so excited about some cow shit? Well, I'll tell you. Fragrant pile of cow manure. Jessica grips the cow pat tightly. Jessica deeply regrets what she just did. I never knew about that until, like, the last time I played this game. I was just like, why would I ever use, like, cow pat? And then I did, and then that happened, and I fucking thought it was so funny. I'm sorry, Jess. I'm sorry I had to make you do that, but... had to. Oh, well, hey. Actually, you know what? Pick him at night. Make it for a good pick. This is the tower, by the way. Oh, come on, dude. Really? Move your ass. Okay, thank you. Dude, seriously. Could you, like, get the fuck out of my shot? Alright, thank you. Oops. Okay. Sorry, for some reason I randomly started thinking about the bunny tail. I'm like, I could have sworn that I was supposed to have gotten one by now. I could have, like, found one. Oh, well, okay, well, doesn't matter. I could have sworn, though. I know I did. The bunny tail plus the hairband.
Yeah.
Yep. Better than the feather cap. Somehow. Might as well do this, huh? Fresh milk plus rennet powder. We'll make two, just as many as we can. Hey, we got two pieces of cheese! And I don't know. Alrighty then. We could go in there, but there's nothing for us. There's nothing in there for us right now. But alright, we can go in there anyway. Just to show it. It's the casino! It's kind of surprising that we're not supposed to take a picture of this place. It's okay to gamble once in a while, but don't forget what we're fighting for. So long as you keep the true purpose of our journey in mind, you won't hear a peep out of me. Are you a bit of a gambler then, Gov? Nah. Me neither. I ain't too good with all the fiddly stuff. I lose a packet whenever I gamble. Nah, I always preferred the safe route myself. There's more dough in them. Ha ha ha. Or no more, of course. What? There's no poker here? I was looking forward to introducing our very own Queen of Diamonds to the rest of the pack. You see, Jessica, you might have won with a good pair in the past, but you need more than that to beat my hand. Like I'd lay my pair on your table anyway, you cheat. And don't go getting up to any of your tricks, okay? You could get into some serious trouble here. Are you worried about me, darling? No, I'm worried about all of us, honey. And there's nothing in here. But we can earn some good prizes, but I'm pretty sure that they never let us actually look at the prizes until we have at least one token. 20. Let's get one. Okay, now we have the privilege to look at the prizes. They got some pretty good stuff here. That's really good, and that's not really good, it's one better. They have an agility ring, which is good, that's actually really good. Titan belt, pretty good. Rune staff is amazing, for something that we need to make later. It's also pretty good now. And platinum headgear, of course, as you can see, is also very good. I never really do anything in this casino, There's a different casino that I do a lot more in, but I might consider doing stuff in this one because, I don't know. If I do, I'll do it off screen because it's not fun to see me, do the slots and then lose and then reload a save. Because yes, I do that. I'm sorry. I know I'm terrible. I don't care. Until I have enough tokens. So, yeah. I don't care. I know some people are like freaking out that I'm using everything on Jessica, but that's how I do things. Like, no, you can't do that! Let's see. Miss anything in here? Oh, I feel like I did. I didn't. I know I didn't. Got everything. Come on, really? Oh, frick! I completely forgot. I need to be looking for the golden slime. And there's really no place here I can think of where, like, oh yeah, that would be a good place. Because this town is all, like, dirty and stuff. So, oh god, it could be anywhere. I doubt I'll find it. Well, who knows, maybe I'll just happen to see it somewhere, maybe. I think this door is locked, right? Yeah, okay. And there's nothing in here, right? I mean, there's something important here later, but right now, not so much. Oh no, yeah, there's some barrels. Is this the fortune teller? No, the fortune teller's over on that side. There are some glorious bags on the wall. Well, this isn't really a wall, it's a tent side. Okay. Okay. Don't want to go down that way yet. Because that's where we need to go. Well, I suppose we could, actually. Because we do need to go back the other way, so yeah, never mind. Yeah, let's go down here. Oh yeah, this guy right here, he's talking about how he's trying to find the guy who... Actually, I'll just talk to him. I heard there was a man who knows everything about everything here. I've come a long way to see him. But I can't figure out where on earth he lives. This town's like a maze. He's down here, dude.
Well, this is brains, is Gaff, but he looks like he ain't home. Ah, well, we better get back to the pub and ask the old codger what he wants to do.
Okay. Let's see. His Majesty said he wanted to have a quiet drink, so I assume he'll find him in the pub. Come to think of it, Brains did used to go off every now and then to get the lowdown on what's going on in the world. Talk about bad timing, eh? Us coming along just as he's off to get on one of his trips. I vote we pick up King Frogface and kiss goodbye to this godforsaken dump right now. Really? I kinda want to explore around some more. You're a strange lady, Jessica. What kind of girl enjoys walking around a grimy, unrefined ghetto like this? Ah, but that explains it. That's why you won't succumb to the advances of a clean-cut, dapper young bachelor like myself. It all makes so much sense. Oh, bravo, Angelo. A positively splendid analysis. Hey, Logan, what do you say we ignore Lord Snooty here and start looking for King Trode ourselves?
See?
Isn't she just so cool? Okay, no. Nah, no more. Well, okay, that's not true. There will be more, just not now. I don't think the church has anything. How many more items we have left? Yangus, tell me. 10.
Ew!
Ooh, 10, huh? I don't know if I know where they are. I know there's some stuff in here. We got on the balcony, but I don't know if there's... Oh, wait, no, wait, wait. That's right, take it with a grain of salt. It actually, even though it says 10, it really is 6. Because there are 4 treasure chests that we can't get to. They're in that locked room. Okay. So that's 5 more. Okay. No. Ah. That... No. A book entitled Fortune Telling for Dummies. You have opened the door to the exciting world of fortune telling and divination. Let us begin with an explanation of how to set up your room. First, cover all the windows, then light some candles, drape some purple cloth around, and top it all off with a crystal ball. Once you've created a sufficiently mystical atmosphere, invite your first customer inside. Remember, never say anything specific during the session, simply say yes, yes, thoughtfully, as you gaze into your crystal ball. If it doesn't seem to be working on your customer, try chanting some made-up spells. Don't forget to wave your arms around and talk about mists clearing. Customers love a good performance. Above all, the more vague, the better. Let the customer fill in the blanks. You'll have a dedicated clientele, in no time. Clientele? I don't know. Pretty sure that they don't say anything until... Yeah. Alright, so we need to sleep. So I guess the fortune teller only comes out during the day. Even though at night would be so much more mysterious, don't you think?